least. Well, we appreciate everybody who's tuning in. And
wait a second. Everybody comes here for violence, but our next opponent, Jason Frito, coming out a peace of love shirt.
Don't trust it. Don't ever trust a man who comes out.
This could be interesting, though. And then we got the Irish leprechaun coming out next.
It looked like he was definitely a Grateful Dead a couple years ago. He looks like he's rolling with a couple of deadheads.
Check his P for THC.
I love it.
Don't check mine.
No.
We got an 0-0 guy taking on a 1-0 guy. John Flansburgh, definitely a crowd favorite. Probably get the biggest pop of the night. Maybe El Shaddai, but still. John got a huge following. Kind of made a statement his first fight. Everybody didn't give him a chance. Came out to a guy that was a lot bigger. Threw that guy around. Surprised us a lot. So this is curious. I don't really know much about this guy.
You know, Jason Frito is 0-0, and he comes out of Pai's Taekwondo. Taekwondo is a great art when you have distance. Flansburgh's the shorter guy. He's got good wrestling. He likes to push the pace. So the story here for me is going to be, can Jason Frito use his techniques to keep Flansburgh at distance? Yep. Jason Frito in the blue corner, blue tape.
And I believe there's like a foot height difference.
Yes. So it's a giant height difference.
How much? I know it's a catch weight. How much do you think he's coming in?
I thought this was cruiserweight.
Okay.
So cruiserweight's about 225. Here we go. We're about to get the pop for the leprechaun.
It's our leprechaun. We love this guy. He weighs 225?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
He's a stocky fella.
He's actually lost weight since his last fight.
Well, again, you know, when you fight in the heavyweight division, you want to be as heavy as possible. But now, since he's going to be able to fight cruiserweight, great weight class for him.
And he has stated he wants to drop weight classes because of his height and his size. But size, skills, heart, probably got the biggest heart out of anybody that would probably fight in the cage. So.
His legs are the same size all the way down. I've never seen anything like that. His calves are enormous.
And he has a good time.
He does. He likes to have fun in there.
Even when he didn't think he was doing good in the last fight, you could tell he was still having a good time. So.
Did we have him around St. Patrick's Day, too, if I'm not mistaken?
It was that, yeah.
We did, right? Yeah, we had the leprechaun.
That's when the leprechaun was born.
We had American Psycho was born tonight.
Man, I really want to see him back. They might not let him in the casino if he has those eyes.
That dude was tired. I felt bad, but nothing beats a win.
We're going to bring it up to Mike Talbot.
The action continues on the card for Cage Wars 59 with our upcoming contest scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds in our cruiser heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. He weighed in yesterday at 226 pounds even. Representing Pies, Taekwondo out of Schenectady, New York, Jason Little J. Frito. And his opponent across cage, fighting out of the red corner. He weighed in yesterday at 225 pounds. Representing Goju Ryu Ki Mixed Martial Arts out of St. Johnsville, New York, the Leprechaun, John Flansburgh.
We're kidding about his legs, Brian. They are one size all the way down.
They literally are. They're tree trunks. Same size.
And again, that's why it's so important for him to get inside and use that leverage, use that low center of gravity.
And for his size, he's very, very fluent with his movements. He switches stances, moves. He closes distance very well,
changes levels.
Here we go. This is going to be fun.
Oh, already. Oh. You heard that pop.
Yep.
And he didn't even do anything yet.
Again, novice rules, so no head strikes for ground and pound.
Flansburgh looking to clear that left leg. Right now, Frito seems to want to just create a little bit of distance. Oh, that's not where he wants to be with Flansburgh. There we go. Look for the rear naked. He's got the chin. Oh, good job by Frito.
Good job of getting up. Oh.
Look at the strength. He gets so
much leverage.
He's got it now. Oh, Fredo's trying to turn. He's trying to push up on that elbow.
He's okay. Give him the thumbs up.
Fredo showing some real heart here.
He is. He's got a roll to his left.
He's not.
Good job by Fredo.
He's not panicking.
I think that just made Flansburgh angry, though.
It did. And Flansburgh right back in the side mount. You know, it's exhausting to get that off you, then get up, and then be taken right back down.
Yep. And this is where both fighters need to be patient and not try to overexert themselves.
Which I would imagine is hard to do, getting caught up in the energy of the moment.
Now, you know, Fredo's got to be careful. Look at that right leg just straight out. Now he's bucking the hips a little bit, but with that right leg straight out, it's going to be easier for Flansburgh to transition.
Now, that's going to open up some big shots, too, with leverage, too.
Imagine if it was ground a pound to the face.
Those aren't doing a whole lot of damage, really.
But again, it's control. He's dominating the round. And I don't blame him for staying here. Get me off of you.
Yeah, Fredo's just got a buck.
But again, coming from a Taekwondo school, who knows what his background is in grappling.
Yeah. Being on your back's a whole different world if you're not used to it.
And right now, you know, he's bucking a little bit, but his shoulders are flat. He's not getting to a hip.
Flansburgh looks really close to throwing an illegal hammer fist. He's got to be
when you
careful.
Have somebody that heavy with that small of a frame and footprint, that's a lot of weight on you.
Great, great opening round here for crowd favorite John Flansburgh, the Leprechaun.
Less than a minute. Again, Fredo's got to push on those hips. He's got to get those knees through.
And I think you can make the argument, too, that Fredo has probably taken some of Flansburgh's best. So, you know, if he's able to get through this round, you might have a tired Leprechaun in round number
looking
two.
Looking for that Kimura.
Kimura.
He doesn't have the angle.
Yeah,
20 seconds. Whoop.
He didn't dig it in.
He's got to lower that arm down.
Step over. Oh, now he can get a straight arm bar out of it, but.
10 seconds.
Good job there by Fredo.
He's remained pretty calm being in that position.
Well, he survived. I mean, the initial onslaught.
Well, yeah, but again, you're calm because you're not getting punched in your face.
Okay.
Yep.
He's asking. He's like,
are you not entertained? I wish I could do an English or Irish accent. Does the leprechaun not entertain you?
Give me my...
I mean, with all due respect, it was a good round. It wasn't a tell me how great I am round.
No. No. But it was domination. You know, Fredo's no worse for the wear. He's not bloody, but he had no answer for Flansburgh's, you know, options and attacks.
But as we've seen, though, you know, three-round fights, a lot changes between round two and round three.
Look at the Christian Blunt fight.
Once fatigue sets in. So the equalizer is fatigue, although Flansburgh says, let's go.
Leprechaun, stay ready. Now, I think Fredo's going to learn his lesson, not rush in.
Look at him, he's having fun, too. Both guys having fun. This is what it's all about.
He's got to utilize that reach. Keep him from shooting in. Good. Nice leg kick.
Those hands are awful low with Fredo.
Well, I mean, the advantage that he has is distance, and he's not using any of it with his hands down. It's okay to be a little bit careless, you know, but you have to be strategic. And just walk right into that.
Yeah. Threw the punch, overcompensated, and ended up easily taken down.
Nice shot by Flansburgh, slowing down the pace. And there's that separation. Fredo's got to scramble. Get up.
That's very good.
There we go. This might be it, folks. That's it.
He tapped.
Flansburgh never stopped until he got it. That's good work.
Now he can say, oh, you entertained?
You've earned it.
He just had trouble standing up. He was almost out, I think.
Here we go. We got the replay coming up. We see him trying to stand up. Brings him right back down to the hip. Transitions right underneath that throat. Oh, punches first.
Made the mistake of
there we
popping
go.
Up. Yep.
And if you notice, he got that hand on the bicep instantly, got that forearm under the throat, and it was a wrap.
You know, he's got a lot of skill. He's going to be tough to beat.
He's very elusive. He can move fast for his size.
Absolutely. And, you know, he's got so much leverage because of just how stocky he is.
Yes.
He's a tough guy to bring down, I would imagine.
He's like the Musa of the cruiserweight division.
He is. He's got some skills. I mean, his body type makes it – possesses some tough mismatches.
He's definitely got a personality, too, and that plays really well to the crowd.
Look at him.
Great show of sportsmanship.
I love to see it. Love to see it. A good win. I'm excited, too, because every time we come back, the level of competition raises. We see a lot of these debut guys, and
we're going to bring it up to Mike Falvo.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for these two great fighters. Referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to the fight 58 seconds into round number two for your winner by way of rear naked choke, John the Leprechaun Flansburgh.
I look forward to hearing what he's got to say to Jay Engleston.
Did he? I think he gifted him the aqua bag too, which is really classy. He's a good dude.
You can't not like the Leprechaun.
You gotta love the Leprechaun.
You either love the Leprechaun or you're wrong.
Or you're wrong. Absolutely.
What a hell of a. What a.
I like him.
What can I say about you? You now you're 2-0.
Yeah.
You prove the doubters wrong every time. Your size doesn't mean shit because of your heart, right?
Yes.
Your octagon awareness, your elusiveness is paramount, and you shock people every time. Take us through this fight, and I'm just blown away by you, man. Good job.
First of all, I just want to say thank all of you for coming out. Without you, there's none of this, so... Give yourself a round of applause for that. But we had a game plan. We had a game plan backstage. Break him down, get him down, and get him out of here. He's a tough son of a bitch. I don't know if I'm allowed to swear or not. Y'all make some noise for him, too, because he got in here. I got one more thing to say. Tim, I want somebody my height or I want a title shot. That 225 title is vacant. And I think I deserve it, so let's run it.
John Flansburgh, everybody.
You know, it's not often that Jay's taller than the person that he interviews.
Yeah. He didn't want